Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the channel and a new little video series here for you guys. I thought this would be kind of cool to do. It's something I've always kind of wanted to see on a channel, but yeah, so I figured, you know, if it's something that I've wanted to see, I'm sure there's some people that maybe want to see it as well. So this is going to be a new kind of mini series, not any gameplay, but just more of an informational type video series. So we're up here at the Clever Motors on Elm Creek, which I'm sure is a sight for sore eyes for a lot of you, but we are here and we're gonna look at some tractor mods. So tractor mods and some implements and things like that. So as you can see by the title of the video, I'm sure, this is all about your 60s and 70s gameplay. I wanted to make kind of like an era's videos where this is all my opinion. I'm sure there's a lot of mods out there that I probably don't even know about. That might have fit well in this series, but I've kind of based it on how accessible the mods are. That's kind of one of the criterias. So like if it's on the mod hub, if it's on an itch page type of thing, or if that modder like intentionally posts their mods to places like King Mods, which is a reliable third party site that works with giants. That kind of thing. But so like if it's a mod that was like posted on a Facebook group or something like that, a lot of the time that's not the most accessible to a large majority of people, just because it's hard to, I've been joining Facebook groups for 3 years now, since 19, so it's, yeah, I don't know. I feel like I'm in a pretty large group, so I get to see those kind of rare mods that people just kind of decide to post in those Facebook groups type of thing, you know. Or another example of it not being very accessible is if it's only posted in a Discord server, that kind of thing. So that's kind of the criteria, is how accessible is the mod, the quality of the mod itself, you know, like the feature, like the look of it, you know, is it a quality looking mod? Another thing is in-game store options, if it's pretty changeable, I guess. So like if you have a lot of customization, that's the word I was looking for. So if you have a lot of customization ability with your mod, that's another thing. So it's just, it's pretty simple, and it's also just completely based off my opinion as well. So this first video is going to be your 60s and 70s equipment. So this is all for your 60s and 70s gameplay. I know a lot of people like to play like a generations type gameplay style, so they can like kind of grow and introduce new tractors type of thing, which would be kind of fun. I kind of want to do that as a series on the channel here. But anyway, so I'm going to stop rambling because this is probably going to be a relatively longish video. So I will make sure to timestamp the different tractors and stuff in the timeline of the video. So you can, if there's a certain tractor you're interested in, you can just go right to that chapter or timestamp, whatever you want to call it. So I have some notes here. So the first tractor we have here is the Massey 100 series. It's by EY Modding, and it is available on the Mod Hub. A little note about this tractor is that it was manufactured from 1964 to 1975 in Detroit, Michigan. So it's kind of cool because that's where, you know, if you don't know, I'm from Michigan, so my home state. So we'll kind of take a look at it here. We'll just hop into it, kind of check the sounds out and what it looks like in cab. So it's a pretty quality mod here for your in cab out of cab play style, so the control pedals work, all that good stuff. The shifter works, all has animations and sounds. So yeah, this was a pretty easy choice for me. I actually did not find a lot of information on this. A lot more of these tractors will have some more background information on, you know, just different cool little tidbits that you kind of found on the internet. But I didn't actually find a ton of information on this. At first, I thought the 175 series was the only series available for the U.S. market. But I later found out through more research that that's not exactly true. I think the 175 series is just the most popular. But anyway, so yeah, we're looking at the 165 series. We'll hop in to the store quick. So we're in here at the store, and we'll kind of go through the options. So the engine options on this mod is a 165. 165 multi-power, 165 multi-power plus turbo, so that adds some horsepower to it. The 175, which runs 65 horsepower, and the multi-power plus the turbo, which boosts it up to 75. 168, multi-power, turbo, 178, multi-power, and turbo. 185, multi-power, and turbo, and the 188, multi-power plus turbo. So that is your highest horsepower that you can get on this tractor, 85 horsepower, which isn't bad. Has a load of wheel options. I'm not going to go through all those. But you can get it with a cab, kind of one of these that doesn't have the back to it, or just standard. Extra front lights. You can get it with weights or a front loader, just a quickie version. And the GPS is just there because I have guidance steering enabled in the mod folder that I'm using right now. So this is our first tractor for your 60s and 70s style gameplay. So next up, we are at the John Deere 4000 series. This is also by EY Modding, and it actually, at the time of recording this video, it pretty much just came out. It was probably 2 weeks ago it came out, and it's on the mod hub. So there's your accessibility qualification for this mod, I suppose. As you look at it, it's a very well detailed mod, very well done by EY. We can hop into it, start it up. It's got good sounds, animations are all there. Can hear the gears shifting, all that good stuff. So that's a pretty much a thing with all of these mods, is they have the animations and they have all that kind of good stuff. So so this 4000 series, it runs a 4000, 4010, and 4020. A little background information on this tractor. It was built in 1969. Total models of these built was 7,987. The 4000 was a high horsepower to weight tractor. It was designed as a runner using the same engine as the 4020, but being almost 1,000 pounds lighter. The 4000 could in the same time pull a four bottom plow fast enough to cover the same acreage as a 4020 with a five bottom plow. The John Deere 4000 was also an economy tractor, providing the same power as the 4020 with fewer features and a smaller rear axle. So some little background information on this tractor. So we'll hop in the store and take a look at it there. So here's the tractor in store. Looks great, has the license plate option if you so desire. So the what we got here for options is a 4000 diesel, 4010 diesel, 4020 diesel, and then you have your 4020 extra power, which puts you all the way up to 101 horsepower. Only got two different wheel brand options, adds wheel weights, narrow tires, wide tires, which is pretty sweet. My opinion, You got your rear twins spread, and then you have your four-wheel drive, or four-wheel assist, I guess, possibly option there, and then your narrows. Anyway, plow duals, all that stuff, so I'm not going to go through the wheel options, but you can have your cab options, your canopy, or your cab. Front weights, we have those installed. You have a front loader. And that are your, those are your options. So it's relatively customizable, lots of wheel options on it, and it's only going to cost you 10 grand. So it's a pretty good option if you're going to be starting a small farm in the 1960s. So next up, we have our Allis D21. I'm sure you guys have seen this on my Richlands, Ohio series. This tractor is by Pleasant View Farms, a good buddy of mine. He did give us some early access to it, and he has done one heck of a job sprucing this thing up. So this tractor was built from 1963 to 1969. The total amount of these tractors built was 1,129, so not a ton of these tractors are actually out there. Horsepower runs 131, I believe, horsepower on this tractor. And this tractor was built in West Allis, Wisconsin. The original price was $5,700 in 1964. So that's actually, I mean, well, looking at it now, in today's economy, that's a pretty cheap tractor. But the D21 was the first Allis Chalmers tractor to have over 100 horsepower. The upgraded D21 Series 2 began a serial number of 2201 in 1965. So this is, yeah, it's a good looking tractor, and this one is available on Pleasant View Farms. Well, it will be available on Pleasant View Farms' itch page. This one actually is not fully released yet. He did release an early release version in his Discord. For those of you that were already a part of his Discord, just kind of as a, you know, kind of a thanks thing. And he was looking for some screenshots for the full release on his itch page. So let's hop into it. Fire it up. So it's got good sounds. And as you can see with this one, the key turns and the push button start pushes in, as well as the clutch. The gear shifter moves, the clutch moves whenever you shift it. The outside guy also moves as you shift it, which is great. Yeah, it's overall just a really nice open cab, older style 60s tractor. So let's look at it in the store now. So here we are in the store. We have a few different wheel setups, set up a little bit different than the other tractors, but we got our Firestone singles with weights, got our big old chunky duals on the back if you want to run a plow with it. We got our diamond singles with duals, continentals with the clamp-ons and the diamonds, and back to the Firestones. So you have plenty of options for tires. I think really all you'd really need with tires, you got your flapper or your stock chrome exhaust pipe there. You can have a 3-point or not a 3-point. And then you have your front weights, which are nicely designed by Pleasant here. So that is it for the tractor here. I don't know why it says total price zero, but maybe that's because we actually are, oh, we already have it, that's why. And we didn't add anything. So this is your D21 Allis. So next up, we have our Farmall 06 series. It's a series of tractors by JCL. Over on his itch page is where he releases all of his mods. So there's your accessibility to this tractor. It was built in Rock Island, Illinois, originally, this series of tractors. And the Farmall 06, or 806 and 706 were introduced in 1963, with production running to 1967. The Farmall 1206 was introduced in 1965 as the most powerful tractor of its time, which is this tractor we have here. It was using a turbocharged diesel engine. Production of the 1206 also ran until 1967, and the 06 series sold very well and was regarded as extremely successful. So that information comes from JCL's release post on his itch page. So let's hop into it. As you can see, the gear shifters and all that good stuff was moving already. Still moving there. There's a lot of different things going on, so I can kind of understand why he decided to forego the animations of the player character. But yeah, I mean, they still move, so if you're playing in cab, you have that kind of immersive type thing. All the gauges are working. The ignition key turns when you start it up. So yeah, it's a good another good 60s created tractor. So we got ourselves four in the 60s era so far. These tractors are not based on a ranking system of any. There's honestly, as we go down, it's just random how I lined them up. There's not like this one was the best and this one was the worst type of thing. So I will catch you guys in the store. So we're here in the store. So this is the range of tractors that you have available to you in this pack. There's three different tractors: the 706, 806, and the 1206 series. I believe they do, depending on which one you do have or you decide to go with, it is, there are different customization options. So you can choose an open cab with the fenders. You can do the windbreaker one, which is pretty slick. Hanneker cab, or back to the open station. Different engine options, which add different horsepowers onto it. And you got your weights. Different weight options there. You have your front loaders. Lizard is the... it comes with a custom front loader for this series tractor. It also comes with the ability to put a cultivator weeder on it, row crop weeder, as well as a blade, I think, was one of the other option with it. You can change your exhaust, muffler, curved or straight. And then you have tons of wheel options with these tractors. So this is your Farmall's 06 series tractors. So next up we have our 86 series Internationals. These are also by JCL. This mod offers a 786, 886, 986, 1086, a Hydro 186, a 1486, and a 1586. So these tractors were originally built in Rock Island, Illinois. And Geelong, Australia, interestingly enough, if I can get those words out. The 86 series were introduced in 1976, and production started in 1977. During this time, they offered the 8860 to the 1586, the 86 to the 162, and the beige paneling and black stripe options. To promote the 86 line and other tractors produced at that time, IH created an event called the Red Power Showdown. During these events, IH would put their tractors to the test and demonstrate how well and what to expect of their tractors. The 86s used in the Red Power Showdown and other events had some styling different only for these occasions. That is in the Red Power paneling and decal, as well as in the IH branding iron decal. After these events, the Red Power tractors were sold at a cheaper price due to the hours already put on them. So, cool little backstory on these tractors. As you can see, I have a few different options already put on these tractors. They are all available with open station. I only have three of the six options that you have. We'll hop in the 786 here. As you can see, we have our animations for starting. We have the animated gear shifters there, as well as the throttle going up and down. And the instrument panel is also very well detailed. Clutch goes in, the throttle engages, and the key turns when you start the tractor up. Lights up when you turn the lights on. All that good stuff. You got a little rattle there on your exhaust pipe. You even got some expiration dates on your fuel filters, which is pretty cool. So, very well detailed mod here by JCL. He does a fantastic job with all of his mods. So, let's hop in a store and see what you have for options in there. So, we're here in the small tractor section of the store. And as you can see, we have our 786, 886, and 986 options here. We'll just check out the 786 here. A few options that you have is an auxiliary fuel tank, which increases your fuel capacity. And it also changes right here where my mouse is. Adds that fuel tank option. You have a different interior packages that you can choose from. You have your red, burgundy, or black. Bunch of different wheel options. Different exhaust options here. You have your open station, four canopy, or your control center, or you have your aftermarket red cab there. You can choose from digital tachometers there, which changes this, or your analog, which is pretty cool. You have your additional lights, rear attachers, you got a top drawbar link, or a third SCV. Or nothing, or both. So then you have your weights, you have control center add-ons, which you have to have the cab enabled for. You can choose to have some turn signals, or you can have a front loader option on it. So those are a few of your options there. If we hop back into the store and we go to medium tractors, we scroll down. You also have four more options of these tractors in medium tractors, which allows you to get a 1586 all the way up to 162 horsepower. So I believe that majority of the options on these tractors are the same, but they're just different engine options type of thing. So you guys kind of see this. You have your 1586 from 76 to 79. You have your red power, or you have your 80, 81, which we won't focus on now because we're doing a 60s to 70s series here. So some of these tractors do overlap into the early 80s. There's actually a lot of tractors available in Farming Simulator that are from the late 70s to the early 80s. So I just kind of had to use my own judgment there to decide, well, is this a 70s or an 80s tractor type of thing? So with this one, we decided that this was going to be in the 70s series. So these are your 86 series tractors, very popular tractors, I know that's for sure, both with real life farmers and us virtual farmers. So next up, we got ourselves another very popular tractor, both in real life and in Farming Simulator. This is the John Deere 30 series. This was produced from 1973 to 1977. This is made by Tired Iron Modding, a very well-known modder in the community. If you're a North American style farm sim player, little background on this. The total number of these tractors built was 15,690, so a pretty good amount of tractors of the 30 series were built. They were built in Waterloo, Iowa. Of course, we all know that. That's where John Deere produce the majority of their tractors. The John Deere 30 series was a direct replacement of the ever popular 20 series, with creature comforts features becoming standard, like a cab. The 30 series was revolutionary and started a 20 plus year era of legendary John Deere tractors. So this is your start to the Soundguard tractors, I believe. So as you can see, very well detailed, nice looking tractor here. Well, we don't want to be in this one. Hop in this one. You can see we pulled the wheel down when we hopped in. We have the shifting gears, obviously. Sound is good. The gauge there moves when we start it up, as well as the fuel gauge and the temp gauge. Those also move when we start it up. So, yeah, it's a really nice tractor. Open station. There's a few different options of this tractor, so let's take a look at those in the store. So here we are in the small tractor section of the store, and this is our mod that we are looking at right now, the 30 series open station. We can choose from the 4020 or the 4230, the 4430, or the 4030. You got your row crop options, weights, you got your wide stance with weights, duals. You can even get your narrow front here with some weights. I like using this narrow front as a option when I'm using it as a feeder tractor, because you can get through a tight barn or something like that, or pen or anything like that, pretty easily. So the front narrows there is a pretty good option for that. You have weight options here. You have your open station or your canopies. Got a front loader option there, the 148. Or the John Deere console if you want to run a newer style loader. So these are your options here for this tractor. We just hopped over to the medium tractor section here in the store, and we have options for the 30 series high crop. You have your high crop options here, all the same configuration options, as well as the cabbed version of the 30 series. In the medium tractors, got your quad range or power shift options on these tractors. Got a mirror option with this one, and flasher options with these as well. So a few different options, but all 30 series John Deere tractors for you. Next up, we're moving into some larger frame tractors here. So this first one is the J.I. Case Traction King. This was manufactured from 1972 to 1978. This is created by Farm Central Seoul for FS. The total number of these built was 5,900, and they were built in Racine, Wisconsin. The original price of these tractors in 1979 was $50,200, so pretty pricey back then. The Case four-wheel drive tractors were really put on the map for sales and production in 1970 by Traction King tractors like the 2470, 2670, and the 2870. There's a really good video on these tractors if you want to learn more about these tractors on the Big Tractor Power YouTube channel, which I'm sure a lot of you probably do follow. I find that if you're a farm sim player, you also do enjoy the other aspect of it, which is real life tractors. So this tractor is another well made tractor with different options. This one is on the mod hub. If we hop into not this one, we want to hop into this guy here. You can see the door opens and closes when we get into it. Fire it up and we have moving instrument panel there. Our throttle moves, gears move, clutch moves, all the things that you'd want to see. This tractor is the crab steering type tractor where all of the tires move, which is pretty neat as well. So as we are in store, this tractor is listed under the medium tractor section. We have our engine options on here, which also changes the design of the tractor, which is pretty cool. So we have the 40 or the 2470, we have the 2670, which just changes the numbers. Then we hop into the 2870, which changes the actual tractor design. Or then we have the 4470 here. So personally, I like the either 2470 or the 2670. We have loads of tire options here. You can go through those. Different window tints. We got wheel weights for it if you want to make it a tillage tractor. Beacon lights. Middle or right side or all sides. You got your front weight options, 100 or 1,000 kilograms there, or you can choose your rim options. Want to go black or whatever you want to do. Then we have our license plate options. So this is your JA Case Traction King tractor. So last in the tractor section here, we have our biggest tractor. This can be found in the large tractor section in the store. This is the Tiger Series, or the Steiger Series 2 by Ballow 2003. I hope I didn't completely butcher your name there. But this is available on the in-game mod hub. This tractor was built from 1974 through 1976. This tractor was manufactured in Fargo, North Dakota. The Steiger four-wheel drive emerged from the Red River Valley region nearly 50 years ago. Brothers Doug and Maurice Steiger built the first Steiger in their Thief River Falls, Minnesota dairy barn during the winter of 1957 and 58. The Steiger number 1 was built from truck components and powered by a 238 horsepower Detroit diesel engine. The simple and powerful design impressed local farmers, and soon the Steiger brothers were building tractors. The Steiger four-wheel drives expanded in 1963 to include a horsepower range from 118 horsepower to 300 horsepower. The success of the Steiger is the main feature was the standard components. Major parts such as engines, transmissions, powertrains were outsourced from brand name suppliers like Caterpillar, Cummins, Allison, Clark, and Spicer. Farmers liked this component because they could find replacement parts nationwide. So, cool little background there on the Steiger series here. There is three other options of these tractors from the same creator in the mod hub, but those tractors were actually more into the late 70s and early 80s. Production-wise, so we probably will hold those off until the next video where we'll be doing the 80s. But so if we just kind of take a look at it, it's a nice looking tractor here. I find that these kind of tractors can be kind of difficult to really detail, just because they're kind of just plain, you know, tractors. But it's very well done. I actually wasn't going to add these tractors originally on the original list, but then I took a look at them in game and I was like, wow, these are very well done. So as we fire it up, see that we got our fuel gauge and our RPM gauge there fired up, moving gear shift, clutch, all that good stuff. The seat actually even moves and all that when we go forwards and backwards. So well done on the interior. You even got your radio panel up there and your fan and heat and windshield wiper control and all that good stuff. So here in the store, we are in the large tractor section in the store. This is where you find this tractor. There's different color configurations you can choose from with this tractor. You can go with the industrial yellow. You can go with the Canadian version, which is a nice orange color. Spirit is 76. It's an American flag style. Export to Hungary. So you got your yellow and white. Blue Steiger. And the original lime green that we all know from the Steiger brand. Your engine options, this one's pretty cool because it actually changes your actual engine in the inside. We have our first one, which is ST300. It's a cat engine, 300 horsepower. I have the next one, which is a Cummins engine, which is actually changes it to a Panther 2. And that runs you 10 horsepower more, 310. And then the ST320, which is a turbo Tiger 2 V8 engine, give you 320 horsepower. So you have three different engine options there, two Cummins and one cat engine. You have a bunch of different tire options. You got your extra work lights that you can add. Actually have different axle options you can choose from, which is pretty neat. You can choose your glass tint. Got your beacon options. You can choose your air filter. Personally, I like this one. Then you have your exhaust type. You can go with the chrome or the straight stack with the flapper. Choose to add a 3-point or not. And then this one's pretty cool because these are one of the few tractors that we have available to us right now in FS22. If you aren't a modder, that you can use for pushing silage. So this comes with a dozer blade, so you have to have this attachment. So if you're looking for a good tractor to push silage with in a bunker, I would highly recommend this one. So you have your dozer blade option, have your front attacher option, which actually you have extra fertilizer tanks that come with this mod as well that you can attach, which is pretty cool if you want to run a planter or something on the back. And then you have your mounted fertilizer adapter or nothing. So yeah, this is these are actually pretty cool tractors. I'm happy that I actually took some time to take a look at these. The other two are also pretty cool, and they come with pretty much the same options of the dozer blade and all that stuff. So we'll look at those ones probably in the 80s series. But yeah, pretty neat tractors, I would have to say. So next up, we're going to move into a few combine options for your 60s and 70s series gameplay. First up, we have the John Deere New Generation Combine Pack from Tired Iron Modding. It's available on his itch page. The first New Generation Pack comes with three different options, which ranges from the 4400, the 6600, and the 7700. The horsepower ranges from 64 horsepower up to 128 horsepower on the 7700 series. Deere releases new generation combines for the 1970 model year. The new lineup included the 3300, 4400, 6600, and the 7700 combines. The 3300 is not included in this pack, I do not believe. The 4400 was Deere's direct replacement for the best-selling 95 series combines, and as such matched many of the earlier machine specifications. So as you can see, it's another very nicely made model by Mr. Tired Iron, who is a wizard when it comes to creating some nice older John Deere mods. So we'll hop into the 6600 here. It's got some nice custom sounds on it. Makes it feel nice and old. You can see the throttle moves there, as well as the RPM gauge. We shut it down and turn it back on. We have different moving gauges there. Cool little ashtray there. I didn't actually ever notice that. So, yeah, we got some nice animations on the inside. The foot pedal moves there, and yeah, it's a nice looking combine. I think it would go great if you are going to run a 60s and 70s series operation. So let's check them out in the store. So we're here in the harvester section of the store. As you can see, we have the 4400, the 6600, and the 7700 versions. One thing I did actually forget that he released is the Laux family 7700 version. This was a special model created for the Laux family, I believe, is who we did it for, where you added duals on it with and a larger grain tank. And kindly enough, those people were happy to allow him to release this version to the public. So yeah, this is a pretty beefy version of the 7700 series combine. I'm definitely trying to find an opportunity to run this combine because it's sweet looking. So anyway, so if we hop into the 6600 series version here, your in-store options, we have gas short exhaust, or we have the gas tall exhaust. We have a diesel short exhaust or a diesel tall exhaust. So the diesel compared to gas actually does change the horsepower on this tractor. So diesel, you're gonna have a lower horsepower compared to the gas. You have different wheel options. You can just go from the standard two-wheel drive option to a four-wheel drive option. Then you have your year models. So you have your 1970 option, 1971 to 72, 71 to 72 with an air conditioning option, 73, 73 with visor, 74, 75, 90, or 76 and 77, which changes the interior a bit there. Your 78, which changes the outward fan there, and back to 70. So as you go through, things actually do kind of change on the model, which is pretty slick. So these are a great option for combines for you if you are going to stick with this era of gameplay. So the last harvester here on the list, there's just two. So this one is the International 14 Series Axial Flow by JCL. This model was originally created by Matt26. That's on the in-game mod hub. But JCL took it and tinkered with it and definitely Americanized it quite a bit. Little background information on this tractor here. This was introduced in 1977. These harvesters marked a departure from traditional combine harvester design, in that threshing and separation was performed mainly by a rotor as opposed to the drum and straw walker type models used previously. The mod edits that he made to this model that are different from Matt's was removing and changing the base model for things that weren't all on the real 14 series. Added different sounds and changed the rear, the skinny rear two-wheel drive wheels. He edited the XML a bit and changed the 1030 to an 820 header and much more. So this one is a pretty cool sounding combine, I know that's for sure. This is one that we used on the Richland series as well. This is Steve's combine that he helped me take down a big harvesting contract with. So hop into it and hear the sounds. Really great sounds on it. Got your moving throttle there, all that good stuff. Got your hour gauge there, as well as some moving gauges also. Very nicely detailed on the inside. So let's take a look at it in the store. So here we have the combine in the store. The configurations are a 1420 and a 1440, 1460 and a 1480. So we can go from 112 horsepower up to 210. Different wheel options for you. The standards pretty much can go from the four-wheel to the two-wheel drive options. Got the wide fat tires there, which is pretty slick. You can go with a short pipe or a middle pipe or a long pipe. So not a ton of customization, but it is a very cool combine that has great sounds and animations and all that good stuff. So it's a great edit by JCL, and we appreciate you Americanizing this version of this combine. So next up, we have a set of Killbros Gravity Wagons here. These are the 300 series, which you have here on the left, the 275 series pack, and which is this one, and then a 300 to 390 series, which has the blue running gear there. This one is by Roosters Mods, and the other ones are by Tired Iron, I believe. Hopefully I didn't get those mixed up. They are available on their respective itch pages. Let's see, the little background information on these was the Killbros was started by brothers Luke and William in the early 1940s. They started making gravity wagons in 1954. Throughout the decades, they continued to improve their design and expand their equipment offerings, which quickly becoming a favorite among farmers. So, lots of different options here on these wagons. As you can see, this one has a ear corn option for it. Not sure how many ear corn actual mods we have, but if there is one out there, this is a great fit for you. We have the Model 350 for this one, and a Model 300, I believe, for this one. Doesn't say the model on this one, but yeah, these are great gravity wagon options for you if you're going to run this style gameplay. As you can see, we actually have different tire options on some of these. This one is Rooster's running gear, his John Deere running gear that he made, which is really great for a lot of these different mods. So, as you can see, kind of the bases of these two are a little bit different because they are on different running gears. But I believe the 270 series comes with an auger option that you can have for a seed tender. We're not going to check these out in game because it would just take a while, because there actually is a lot of different options for these. But yeah, these are your Killbros Gravity Wagons by Roosters Mods and Tired Iron Modding. So as we're nearing the end here, we have ourselves a few implements. There's not a lot of implements available for this style gameplay, so you're going to kind of have to use your imagination a bit if you're going to do that. I was not able to find any seeders or planters for this era, but I found a few things that you can use. So first up, this is the both of these mods are made by Rooster. Again, they are on his itch page. The 55 chisel series plow was a primary tillage tool manufactured by International Harvester for many years, starting in 1970. The chisel plow is modeled after one that was made in the early 70s. So this one here, this one's pretty cool because you can actually change your different types of shoes that you have on there. So I like the twisted ones, as that's what we use in real life on the farm that I work for. So that's the option I always go for. Don't know why, but that's my reasoning, I guess. So this is a good chisel plow for you for this era, as well as a John Deere 400 rotary hoe. It's an implement that was manufactured by John Deere from 1960s to the 1990s, so a 30-year period there, and it was one of the more popular rotary hoes on the market. The rotary hoe is an essential tool for farms that don't or can't use herbicides. So if you're organic nowadays, you do not use herbicides, so you are out in the field cultivating a lot. So if you want to run an organic option, this is a great one for you. It works by distributing the very top layer of the soil early in the growing season and uprooting weeds that have just started to sprout. So with this mod, you have to get the weeds early, or else if they've grown past the early stage, you are not able to take them out with this weeder. So we have ourselves a few honorable mentions here. I thought these were pretty good to add in quick. We're not going to do a whole lot, but this, these two are semi-trucks. There's three here, but two different pack mods. So first up, we got a 1967 Peterbilt 357. This is by Crownzilla on his itch.io page. It was manufactured from 1967 to 1987, the 359 series. This was Peterbilt's first long hood truck. It was long, it was big, and it contained a lot of power. So this is your Pete. That's not your Pete, this one is. Got some nice sounds to it. Pretty decent looking model on the outside. Nice horn sound on it with those big air horns on the top. And then you got your big old Pete steering wheel. It's pretty customary for these era of trucks. So as we move the headlights on, you can see that you have different animations on the instrument panel there. So well done there. Fire it down and the ignition stops. So this is a pretty well done mod there by Crownzilla, and great for your for this era of farming if you want to run kind of a bigger operation with some semi trucks and stuff like that. Next up we have a very well known mod in Farm Sim right now. So this was another one by BC Buehler. This is a Mack RS700L. The L I think stands for aluminum frame, pretty sure. This is manufactured in 1967, this truck. So this is either a grain truck here option, or it has a hopper bottom, a dual hopper bottom grain trailer that you can hook up to the actual semi truck option here. As we all know, BC Buehler does amazing work with his mods. Just everything is just incredibly detailed. We have your gear shifter moving all about. All that good stuff. The interior is just extremely well detailed. So, here is your Mack grain truck pack. So, that is going to be it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed this kind of mini series that we're going to be doing here on different eras of equipment. Next up will be the 80s. I think I'm going to try and release one video per week on this type of thing. So, yeah, got ourselves a lot of really nice equipment here, and I hope this gives you some inspiration for your next gameplay save. And as always, thank you for watching, and I will catch you guys in the next video.